I got a question for you. Did you ever hear the expression, the money's in the follow-up? Well, what they're talking about is an email follow-up series. Hey, my name's Lamar Scholl. Welcome to the video, and I want to thank you for stopping by. I was just checking to see if my mic was on. So yesterday we talked about, well, we talked about traffic the day before, then yesterday we talked about leads. So now that we have those leads into your email, what do you do with them? And that this is the one of the first things you want to do is send them through a follow-up series, and we're going to learn that today. So let me take you over to my monitor and we're going to get going. So day three, we're going to talk about email follow-up series. First of all, what is a follow-up series? Hey, why in the heck do you need it at all, right? And then how to craft those high converting emails. All right, let's talk about what an email follow-up series is. This is a series of emails that have been previously written, hopefully by you, but they could be written by somebody else. And what I mean is you want them to be written by you because then it will include like your personality, everything like that in there. The follow-up series is something to get your leads familiar with you, and we're going to talk about that in a little bit. But these are emails that have already been written. They're already loaded up in your autoresponder. I'm going to show you all this later, so don't worry about it. If you're not like that techie, don't worry, we got you covered. We got you covered right here. So these are, like I said, previously written. And what happens is as your leads come in, like we were talking about yesterday, come into your email service provider or autoresponder, the same thing, they'll be automatically taking through this follow-up series. This happens automatically 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Once you have the emails done, you don't have to worry and lift a finger anymore. This is one of the coolest advantages to an autoresponder. So if you get 50 leads today, all 50 of those leads will automatically go through your follow-up series, and you don't have to do a darn thing. How does that sound to you, right? These autoresponders are pretty, pretty nifty. You know, you can decide to have as many or as few emails as you want in a campaign, which is a follow-up series. A follow-up series can consist of one email. It can consist of 360 emails, 45, whatever you feel. So there's no common, no normal, anything like that. It's really what you're trying to do. So that's, you know, so that's the number of emails and how this runs. And also the autoresponder will do, you know, send out the time. You can configure the time between the emails. So typically, right, you will do an email, 24 hours go by, another email, 24 hours go by, another email. You can configure all that in the autoresponder, the number of emails and the time between. And they don't have to all be the same in the same follow-up series, the time between. Like you, the first two emails could go out within hours of each other. So the first one automatically goes out the minute they opt in, and then the second email could go out 3 minutes later, 3 hours later, the next day, the next week. You're the one that controls all that. So a follow-up series is also called a campaign. So that's what I was using before. So they're exactly the same thing. Some people call them an email campaign. Some people call them an email follow-up or a follow-up series. So I'm going to use my little cursor here to help me stay organized so I can explain this to you as best I can. So this is the diagram of what an email follow-up series looks like. So we talked about leads yesterday. When your lead comes into your ESP, your email service provider autoresponder, it will automatically send out the first email as soon as they opt into your landing page. And then the next day, email two will get sent, then email three, and then email four, and then five. So all these, you know, assuming they're a day apart. Now, like I was saying before, I can have 3 hours between this email and this email. I can have a week or a month, but you know, that's easily configured in the autoresponder. It's not that hard to do. It's very, very simple. So this would be just a follow-up series or campaign with five emails in it. All right, so now, the email follow-up series. What we want to do, like, why? Why do you need a follow-up series, right? Why do I need this? Well, this is probably the workhorse of your whole business, right? So the purpose of using a follow-up series or an email campaign is you want to get the leads to know, like, and trust you. Think about it. When you go to make a purchase of any kind, don't you have to trust that person that's selling, whether it's a service or a product to you first, right? You're not going to trust a total stranger. So this is what I was talking about before. So when you write your own emails, you're using your personality. You don't want to be like somebody else, right? People, you want to attract people that are attracted to you. So you want to write by using your personality. You can definitely, and absolutely I do, I look at other people's emails to get ideas and to, you know, to see what they're doing and see what works out there for sure. I don't sit there with a blank screen from scratch, and nobody should. And we're going to talk about that in a little bit in this video, but let's get back to why we want the emails here. So you want these leads. What you're doing is having the leads warm up to you, right? So this is part of that onboarding process, right? Once you get that lead, you're working them toward a sale, a purchase, right? Now, in these emails, you want to deliver value to your leads. Look, these leads are people, right? Just like you and me. I want to keep reminding you of that. I forget from time to time. A lot of, you know, it seems like a lot of us tend to do that. But the more you know and kind of keep it up here in your head that, you know, these leads are people too, right? And so now you want to deliver value. You want to teach them things every day. Not every day, but a lot, right? So what I do is I send out like 75% of my emails are value-based, right? So that's teaching them value. And then maybe the fourth email is more or less I'm selling. I'm not telling them to buy it. I'm not spamming or anything, but I'm just kind of, I'll be probably more focused on helping them by mentioning the product more, right? So once you have people warm up to you, because it's like, hey, you know, you start looking like an authority in your space now. Hey, this person knows something, right? So this is awesome. I'm learning stuff. So the chances are pretty good that they're going to purchase your product or service, whatever you're selling. And the nice thing, like I mentioned before, this follow-up series is complete autopilot. Once you write the emails, you're done. Hands off, right? So as those leads are coming in, they're receiving those emails. Your autoresponder is doing all the heavy lifting. And that's, like I was saying before, one of the coolest things. Now, the next thing and the last thing I want to talk to you about today is how to craft high converting emails. And I talked about a lot of this stuff already, but let's just go over it. So we talked about a landing page or a capture page. I never really showed you one. Maybe I'm going to do that in tomorrow's video. So what I'm talking about is like when you bring that lead into a lead, a landing page or a capture page are the same thing. What I do, I have two fields on there. One is the obvious one. It's the email. And the other one I put on there, I collect just the first name of the lead. And the reason why I do that, so I can really personalize the emails. And I like doing that. And you can use their name, believe it or not, up in the email subject lines. And once again, the autoresponder does all that trickery. It's not hard. That's really, really cool stuff. And that's one of the things you're going to learn if you click on the button down below for Mass Traffic Institute. And they got all these kind of tips in there on how to get to write better subject lines so that more people will be wanting to click on your email and say, hey, I want to check this out, right? So I want to make sure, like, because there's a lot of marketers that don't put anything but just the email on the capture page. And you will get more opt-ins for sure, because it's more of a, you're asking for a little bit more, you know, so you're putting up a little bit more barrier there, entry barrier, you know, you're asking to put two things in instead of just one. The way I look at it is if the, you know, the lead doesn't want to put their first name, you know, as opposed to just their email address, they're probably not going to buy from you anyways. I mean, there's no guarantee, there's no way to prove, but I make sure in the field, I don't ask for full name. I, you know, respect people's privacy. Just the first name, please. That's all I want them to put in there. All right. Now, the second one here, don't spam by putting a lot of links in the email. And this is what I was kind of saying before, right? Make sure you write the email like you're writing to your friend, believe it or not. Because would you send your friend an email with just a bunch of links in it? Probably not. So you don't want to do this to your leads coming in. You want to always keep in mind, I'm going to mention it again, that they are also a person just like you. They have feelings, they have beliefs, everything just like you do, right? And then what I do is in my email content, I mentioned this before, I mix it up. I do about 75% value-based emails, right? So I'm teaching something every day in marketing. And then every fourth one or so, it's a rough thing, right? It's about one quarter, 25% of the time, right? I'll send out an email that it's not telling them, hey, buy this now. You don't want to do that, but it's more focused on the product, right? And how it would help them. And the other thing, the last one's key. I often find out what my subscribers want. And you can do this by sending out a survey. And this is cool because listen, you know, like a lot of times I sit there and say, man, I wonder what my subscribers want to know. What do they want to know? What do they want to know? What are their problems? What can I help them with? Right? So I send out surveys with some questions and they just answer them. And then whatever gets the highest, you know, most picks, right? That's what I base my emails on. So they're kind of helping doing my job for me. So that's the end of our video today. I'm trying to keep this one short because these have been kind of going pretty long. But my name again, once again, is Lamar Scholl. And if you want to know more about marketing, just click on that button below. I will be the person that will be helping you if you have any questions at all. I've been going through Mass Traffic Institute. Actually, I've been through it twice now. I love it. It's awesome. It's a great course, and it's going to teach you everything we've been talking about in the last 3 days. So tomorrow, I'm going to show you what a landing page looks like, and I got something special in store for you. So you're going to have to wait till then. All right, I will see you tomorrow.